Hello mga ka-agri, this is AgriTalks PH. Today we will be talking about the history of soil science, how it developed from time to time. Okay, so soil science was originally one of the branches of geology. So geology is the study of the earth. So soil science is just under in the natural resources, which is one of the branches of geology. But during 19th century, soil science was officially considered as an independent natural science, which was argued or proposed by the scientist named Frederick Fallu, and he was the founder of soil science. He argued that soil science should be studied separately and independently, and we should focus to study about soil since it is a very important resource. Soil science primarily concerns before about agricultural problems in order to increase productions by improving the fertility status of the soil. So here are the three periods of soil science development. First, we have the ancient period. So during 4,000 years ago, Chinese attempted to classify soil. So basic classification, which is arable or not. So when we say arable, a soil that can be planted or a soil that is good for crop production. And then during 2,000 years ago, the Greeks and Romans started engaging in simple soil studies. Okay, so, and then 371 to 286 before Christ, Theophrastus, which is a Greek, gave the name of the soil edaphos. Okay, so he described soil properties that affect plant growth. So that is Theophrastus. So during 234 to 149 BC, Cato developed a classification system of arable soils. So he classified a soil if it is arable or not. So when you say arable, it is suitable for planting of crops. So he also emphasized the suitability of soils in farming. So during pre-soil science period, it is the time before the soil science was being formally accepted as a natural science, we have this scientist named Justus von Liebig. He established the agricultural chemistry and also formulated the mineral theory of plant nutrition, or also known as the law of minimum. So here is the picture of Justus von Liebig, and this is the diagram showing the law of minimum. So this briefly explains the law of minimum. So we have this jar made of wooden stick, and each stick represent the nutrients or elements, and then what is inside of this jar is the crop yield. The law of minimum states that crop yield is dependent on the most limiting nutrients. Okay, so ibig sabihin, pag one of these nutrients are limited or kulang, ang mangyayari sa crop yield, mag-reduce or bababa kasi merong kulang na nutrients. So crop yield is dependent on the most limiting nutrient. Like for example here, the nitrogen is the most limiting nutrient. So therefore, it can affect the crop yield. So that's the meaning of the law of minimum. Next, we have Henry Darcy. So he developed the law in soil physics, which is the Darcy's law, which describes water flow in the soil. And we have also Joseph Henry Gilbert. So he established the first systematic long-term field fertilizer experiment, which was conducted in the world-famous Rothamsted Experimental Station at England, United Kingdom. Next is the early soil science period. So this is the time wherein soil science was already and officially accepted as an independent natural science. So we have Frederick Fallu. So he was the founder of soil science, since he was the one who argued for the recognition of soil science to be an independent natural science, which will be separated from geology. So his argument are found in his book entitled Pedology of General and Special Soil Sciences. Next, we have Vasily Vasilievich Dokokaev. So he was considered as the father of modern soil science because of his significant works in soil science. So his discussion about five factors of soil formation was found in his book entitled Russian Chernozem. Another, we have this Eugene Hilgard. So he was also the father of American soil science because he was the one of the first to apply soil science to solve the problems in agriculture, particularly in America. So next we have Hans Jenny. So he was the student of Dokokaev. Okay, so he was the one who further discussed in his book entitled Factors of Soil Formation. So he focused on the discussion of these five factors of soil formation. That's why the credit belongs to him right now, since he was the one who further discussed about these factors. But the original who introduced these five factors of soil formation was Dokokaev. So Hans Jenny gave this formula of soil formation, that soil is a product of climate, living organism, relief or topography, parent material, and time. So that's Hans Jenny. So soil science has an organization. We have this International Union of Soil Sciences, or the IUSS. So it is a global scientific organization of the several soil scientists and soil science practitioners. And also, this IUSS was a full member of the International Council for Sciences. And then we have also divisions of soil science, or branches of soil science. First, we have soil genesis. It studied about how the soil was being formed and where does the soil was originated from. That is soil genesis, from the word genesis, that is origin. Soil survey and classification. So it studied about the different classification of soil. So the different soil orders. Okay, that is soil survey and classification. Soil physics talks about the physical properties of the soil, like the water movement, the structure, the texture of the soil, the bulk density and porosity. That is for soil physics. Soil microbiology and biochemistry, or the soil ecology, talks about the microorganisms in the soil, like soil fungi, soil bacteria, and many more. And also, the soil fertility talks about the importance of soil to the plant nutrition or the plant growth. So, it studied about the soil that supplies nutrients to the plant. That is soil fertility. Soil mineralogy and chemistry talks about the mineral component of our soil. And then the chemical properties of our soil like cations exchange capacity and other chemical components of the soil. Lastly, we have soil and water conservation. So it talks about how to control soil losses and water losses. So that is soil conservation. Like for example, how to control soil erosion, how to conserve water by minimizing water evaporation. So that is soil and water conservation. So that's all for today, guys. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe.